I now request Mr. Bharathan Doshi, trustee of our Lalit Doshi Memorial Foundation, to introduce to us our speaker today, Mr. Shaktikanta Das.
Good evening, friends. It is my privilege and honor this evening to introduce Mr. Shaktikanta Das on the occasion of the 29th Lalit Doshi Memorial Lecture. I have known Mr. Shaktikanta Das for many, many years. And I've also had the pleasure of working with him on the Central Board of Directors of Reserve Bank of India. And more particularly, after he joined as the governor in 2018 and before my term as Central Board Director ended in 2020. Before I commence the introduction, I would request all of you to join me to give a big applause for the governor for being recently confirmed with the Central Bank Governor of the Year Award 2023. In my introduction, I will try to highlight some of the lesser known aspects of his brilliant career beyond the brief bio sketch, which is with the invitation card, which is with all of you. He was born in 1957 in Bhubaneswar, Odisha. He completed his master's degree in history from St. Stephen's College in the University of Delhi. Very few people know that immediately after completing his MA, he started teaching at Sri Venkateshwar College in Delhi and took the immediately junior class of MA at the Delhi University. He's a polyglot. He knows English, Hindi, Odia, Tamil. Today's lecture is in English. He entered the Indian Administrative Service in the year 1980 as an official of the Tamil Nadu cadre, and his career progressed as assistant collector, undersecretary, deputy secretary, managing director of TNPL, and other positions in the hierarchy. He had two separate terms as Industry Secretary Tamil Nadu, once from 2000 to 2001, and again from 2006 to 2008. He was the architect of developing the Sriperumbudur Industrial Belt, which attracted prestigious automobile and electronic projects like Renault-Nissan and Dell Computers. He was responsible for Tamil Nadu's successful SEZs and industrial policy. It is pertinent to mention that Lalit Doshi was industry secretary in Maharashtra and played a major role in formulating the new industrial policy for the state of Maharashtra. During the interaction between industry and government, there was a great similarity between Mr. Shaktikanta Das's approach and between late Lalit Doshi's approach. They fully understood the cost of hardship and the role of incentives and the impact of incentives. They both adhered to principles and yet were pragmatic. Das demonstrated his persuasive power by being able to convince formidable chief ministers of Tamil Nadu at different points in time. He later moved to the Ministry of Finance, where he served in various capacities, including Secretary of Revenue and Economic Affairs. During his long tenure in Ministry of Finance, he was in the Government of India. He was directly associated with preparation of as many as 8 union budgets. His objectivity was obvious as he worked with finance ministers with different ideologies and with different political backgrounds. As the Secretary in the Department of Economic Affairs from 2015 to 2017, he played a key role in demonetization, implementation of GST, and steering in the insolvency and bankruptcy code. Das is the man who has seen both the sides of economic governance, the finance ministry as well as RBI, fiscal as well as monetary. In 2017, he was appointed as India's Sherpa for the G20's development track and played a crucial role in shaping the G20's economic agenda and policy decisions. His contribution to global economic issues helped to advance India's interests and priorities, cementing his reputation as a distinguished public servant. His accomplishments and leadership earned him the prestigious appointment as the 25th governor of the Reserve Bank of India in 2018. It was a time when the finance ministry and the Reserve Bank of India had many differences. And the government perhaps at that point in time preferred a seasoned civil servant as against a seasoned economist. Many skeptics questioned the appointment of a student of history for an economist role. What Das achieved over the next 5 years was a wide-scale admiration for his expertise in macroeconomic policies, financial sector reforms, and public finance. Central Banking London lauded Das's handling of multiple crises and black swan events. It said, his tenure, which began in December 2018, has been marked by a series of grave challenges, starting with the collapse of a major non-bank firm, moving through the first and second waves of the coronavirus, and then in 2022, Russia's invasion of Ukraine and its inflationary impact. Central Banking further added, but it has also been the same time of a spectacular innovation for the RBI and for India as a whole. Hence, sir, the Central Bank Governor of the Year Award is a true recognition of your qualities of vision and leadership. While witnessing firsthand in the ring, as one says, watching his remarkable career, what stood out for me was his commitment to public service, hard work and dedication, and above all, his humility. It is said of him, he is nimble-footed and open to ideas, a trapeze artist, a master of the finest balancing act, who listens to all but takes his own decisions. Sir, hope one of these days you will write your autobiography and we will see your journey as a policymaker across the terrain of industry, economics, and finance through the eyes of a history student. Friends, we all can now look forward to a very interesting lecture this evening when the governor shares some of his reflections on building blocks for a sustainable future. Thank you.